Dear students, this video tells about how to test the functional group present in organic compound. First one is test for unsaturation. Unsaturation organic compound can be tested by using bromine water test and Bayer reagent test. In bromine water test, when alkene gas passes into the bromine water, red color bromine water, it becomes colorless. When alkaline KMnO4 solution treated with alkene unsaturated hydrocarbon, it becomes colorless. Potassium permanganate changes into colorless. Alcohol test for alcoholic functional group. Alcohol functional group can be tested by using sodium metal test. So when sodium metal is added to anhydrous alcohol, it releases hydrogen gas. Alcohol functional group can be tested by using ester test. In this, alcohol can be react with carboxylic acid in the presence of concentrated sulfuric acid. It releases fruity smell. So that is indication of alcohol. Iodoform test can be conducted for the detection of alcohol functional group when alcohol is heated in the presence of sodium hydroxide. In the presence of iodine, it gives dark yellow color PPT. The phenolic functional group. The phenolic functional group can be tested by using simple litmus test. When litmus paper is added to the phenol, it gives red color. And second one is perchloride test can be conducted with this phenol. It gives violet complex. Test for carbonyl groups. The carbonyl groups can be tested by using 2,4 DNP test, where the 2,4 DNP can be tested. So for carbonyl groups, aldehydes and ketones, where it gives yellow color precipitate. 2,4 DNP will give yellow color precipitate with the carbonyl compounds. The second one is sodium bisulfite test. The sodium bisulfite, when salt is added to the aldehyde and or ketone, it gives white color precipitate. Another one is Schiff's test. Aldehydes gives magenta color. So when Schiff's reagent is added to aldehydes, it gives magenta color. Next one is Tollen reagent test. The Tollen reagent test is ammonical silver nitrate. So when added to the aldehydes, so the aldehydes changes into carboxylic acid. In this, the silver ions changes into metallic silver, where the silver precipitate is deposited on the test tube. Another one is Fehling solution test. The Fehling solutions are A and B. When added to the aldehydes, then the cupric ions changes into the cuprous. So then red color PPT we can get. Test for ketones. The ketones can be tested by dinitrobenzene test, dinitrobenzene test, and sodium nitroprusside test. Nitroprusside ion will give the red color with the ketone. The test for carboxylic group. The carboxylic group can be tested by litmus test, where it blue litmus changes into red color. Sodium hydrogen carbonate is the suitable test for carboxylic acids, where it releases CO2 gas brisk off with effervescence. Ester test can be conducted for this carboxylic acid like alcohols, where it gives the fruity smell ester, so we can get. Test for amines. So amines can be tested by using, number one is litmus test, where the litmus paper changes into red color to blue. The carbolamine test is most convenient one to test the amines, where it can give isocyanide formation, which is the foul smell. Other one is azodite test. The azodite test can be conducted for this amine, primary amines, which gives yellow color precipitate. Nitrous acid test also will be conducted for detection of primary amines. The primary amine can be detected by using nitrous acid, then it gives the nitrogen gas and nitrous acid. The secondary amines can be tested to form nitrosoamine. Tertiary amines can react with the nitrous acid to form soluble nitrate salts.
Thank you for watching.